Hi guys, and welcome back to a new video. Today we're doing quite a fun video, which is a rundown of every single book on my physical TBR. Now, I'm conscious that it's going to be a long video, so I'm not going to waffle for too long in this intro. But the whole gist of me doing this is because I want to do a bit of a TBR takedown. So I've seen Ellen Catherine, I think that's her name. She is another booktuber and she's done a TBR takedown series before. And I kind of need to do that. So I've done quite a big book haul recently, which if you haven't seen, I'll link and then you can go and watch it. So I did a big book haul and now I'm kind of like, need to get through some of my TBR. So I'm going to do some TBR takedown videos in the next couple of months. But before we do that, I wanted to give you a rundown of every single book I have, and then you know what to expect in the next couple of months, and you can kind of give me an idea of what you want me to read. Comment below a book in this video that you've read that you think is really good or you'd like to see me read, and then I can kind of move that higher up on my priority. Or if there's one you think I'm not going to like, then give me a hint so I know to prioritise other ones instead. The last time I counted, I had about 60, and I have read some since then, but I have also bought some too. So we'll see whether we're still at 60 or a bit more or a bit less or whatever. So let's just jump straight into today's video because I think it's going to be a hefty one. So I'm going to start with my bookshelf. I do have a shelf at the bottom, so I might start there because you actually can't see that shelf. So it might be easier if I just grab the books off and show you from there. So we've got The Infinity Between Us, which I think is kind of like Every Summer After, and I absolutely adored that book. So I'm super excited to read this. I don't know too much about it, but yeah, people have said it's kind of like Every Summer After, but I'm waiting for warmer weather to read this. We've got Bloodstream, which I think is kind of like an F1 or at least a motorsport romance. I believe she is a social media manager and he's an F1 driver or a racing driver, which is so interesting and such a cute concept. And if you didn't know, I'm actually I work in marketing for a motorsport company, a racing company. So that's very exciting, and I am an F1 girly through and through. Then I have The Right Move and Caught Up from the Windy City series, which are books 2 and 3, as I've read the first one. The first one was not my favourite, but people have said that the other ones are much better, and I think The Right Move is most people's favourite in the series. So I'm still going to give them a go, and I think there is another one coming out this year as well, and I think there might be one more after that in the series. So I need to get to these at some point. Then we've got The Dead Romantics by Ashley Poston, or Poston, however you say it. The 7-Year Slip by the same author is literally one of my favourite ever books. I loved it. I actually had it as a proof copy from Mills and Boone, and I was absolutely... Was it Mills and Boone? I think so. And it was absolutely one of my favourite ever books. So I do need to get around to reading this, but I'm not sure whether to save it for like autumny, wintry time, as it's giving like cozy, spooky vibes. Then I have The American Roommate Experiment, which is by the same author as The Spanish Love Deception. I did really like that book, so I am wanting to read this one, and I've heard that other people really like this one as well, so if you've read it, let me know. I also have The Long Game, which is by the same author. So I haven't actually heard too much about this, but like I said, I quite liked The Spanish Love Deception, so hopefully I should like that one. I then have 3 of the books from Ella Mays's kind of interconnected standalone series. So I've got To Love Jason Thorne, which I believe is like a movie star romance. To Hate Adam Connor, which I'm not sure about, but I'm assuming it's a Enemies to Lovers book. I could be wrong. And then Marriage for One, which is a marriage of convenience type romance. I then have Love and Other Words by Christina Lauren. I've heard so many good things about this, and I think because I've heard so many good things, I'm so scared to read it. But I do need to just get over that fear and just give it a read, because again, I've just heard such good things, and I think it might be like a childhood friends to lovers. I could be wrong, but I think that's the gist of this book. I then have Bad Girl Reputation by Al Kennedy, which is part of her Avalon Bay series. I did read Good Girl Complex. I did quite like that book, not as much as I loved her hockey romances, but I just love Al Kennedy's writing. And I've had this book for so long, I just haven't got around to reading it yet. And I believe there is actually a third one in this series now that I do not have, but I do want to read. So I need to just get around to reading that. Then have The Graham Effect, also by Al Kennedy. This is a recent purchase, so that's why I haven't read it yet, but I am hoping to read this really soon as I absolutely loved the deal and was obsessed with Garrett Graham. And then Al Kennedy's most recent book is Girl Abroad, so I have this one as well. I wasn't actually going to buy this, but then I heard someone talk about like the synopsis of the book and it just sounded right up my street, so I am now going to give this a read because it sounds very exciting. I don't know when I'm going to get to it, but it is like relatively high on my priority list to read. Slight change of angle as the lighting is better this way, and obviously you can then see the bookshelf a little bit better. I'll do this shelf and then I'll do that one. So I have Throttled by Lauren Asher, which is an F1 romance and the first book in the Dirty Air series. Just haven't got around to reading it yet. There's mixed reviews on the Dirty Air series, and apparently the last one is the best book, but there's like three books before that, so I'm kind of have my reservations about getting to it. So I feel like I will read it eventually because, like I said, I am an F1 girly. It's just actually getting the time to get around to reading this. I then have the next two books in the Dreamland Billionaire series. Now, I've read the first one. I hate to say it, but I really didn't like it. So I'm kind of like, I'm in an RN. I do believe the other ones are better. I just really didn't like the first one. It just kind of was a bit cringe for me, so I know some people really like that book, but yeah, I just kind of need to get over that and just get around to reading them. But I think they're scaring me because they're so hefty. And I have The Devil in Blue Jeans. Is that how you say it? Yeah, I keep going to say the wrong thing. This name just doesn't flow off my tongue. But this is a cowboy romance. This is a recent purchase. That's why I haven't got around to it yet. But I do think I'll get around to it soon because it's only short and I'm in my cowboy romance era at the moment. I then have the last three books in the Chestnut Spring series. I absolutely love this series, but I just have not got around to reading these yet. I have had Powerless and like quite a few of my monthly TBRs and just to get to it. But I really just need to just pick it up and just read it, and I think once I've got back into it I want to read all of them. I especially want to get to Reckless because I know that that's a lot of people's favourite and they really like Theo, so yeah, I just need to put my big girl pants on and just read these. I then have Hook, Line and Sinker, which is the second book in the Interconnected Standalone series, or duology. I don't actually know what it's called. It's just called the Bellinger Sisters duology. So this is the other one from It Happened One Summer. I loved It Happened One Summer and I do think I'm gonna like this. I'm just kind of waiting for warmer weather to read it so I'm in the right mood for it. I then have the three books in the Hot and Hammered series by Tessa Bailey. So that's Fix Her Up, Tours of Engagement and Love Her or Lose Her. I don't know which order that they come in, but I'm pretty sure all of these are part of the same series. I just haven't got around to reading them. I have so many Tessa Bailey books that I just haven't read yet, but I did really like It Happened One Summer. I have read some others, so I've read Window Shopping and My Killer Vacation, which wasn't the best, but it was all right. So yeah, I just haven't got around to reading these ones yet. I then have another duology by Tessa Bailey, and I believe this is called Vine Mess or something, which I literally didn't know until I just looked in one of the other books. But that is the Secretly Yours and Unfortunately Yours, which I believe both are Marriage of Conveniences, which is not my favourite trope, but I heard good things about this book and it was a Tessa Bailey book, so I just kind of picked them up. I feel like I will get to them, but not for a while. I then have Chase Me from the Broken Beautiful series by Tessa Bailey. I don't have the other ones in this series, but yeah, it was a Tessa Bailey book. I just picked it up. I'm probably not going to read it for a while, but. I then have X's and O's and The Catch, both by Amy Lee, or Amy Leah, however you say this book. I did read Set On You, which is the first book. I think they're all connected. I think they're like interconnected standalones. I know definitely that this one is. I'm not sure about this one. So I read the first one and I did not like it because the male main character reminded me of someone and it gave me the ick. So that was just my personal experience with the book. Other people probably aren't going to have that, but that was just my personal experience. So I didn't like that one, but I didn't want to write off the author because I think it was just that character in that book. So I am going to read these. I am wanting to read them, but again, I'm just feel like I need a bit of warmer weather. They seem more like springy, summery read. Then have The Switch by Beth O'Leary. I did read The Flatshare. It was okay. I know a lot of people really like that book, but it just wasn't my favourite ever book that I've read. But I still do want to read this one. It's just not so high on my priority TBR. Then have Maggie Moves On by Lucy Score. Again, I do want to get around to reading this. It's just not a priority for me right now. I have some other books that I want to get to first. We are now onto the last shelf of this bookshelf. So I have Magnolia Park's Into the Dark, which is the last book that's currently out in the Magnolia Park series. I am scared of reading this book. I do want to get to it really soon, but I am super scared of reading it after I've seen so many people crying and I literally had my heart broken in the last two books. So just a bit worried about reading this one, but I do really want to read it. Then I have the second and third book in the ACOTAR series. I recently read A Court of Thorns and Roses while I was on holiday, so you can actually watch that video if you want to. And I liked it, but didn't love it. However, I didn't like the character she was with in the first book, but I know that she's with a different character in these. And a lot of people say that the story gets so much better. So I am going to read these very soon because I just want to get around to reading them and I'm excited to see what all the hype is about. That's where I'm at. I am going to read these very, very soon. So there will be in a video quite soon. And that is actually everything on that shelf because I've read everything else currently on here. So let's move on to my cart. I'm not quite sure where to start. I have some books like at the back. So I might start with those. I have King of Wrath by Anna Huang, is that how you say it? I don't know what this series is called, but it's like a separate series. I have not got around to reading this yet, to be honest, but I do want to read it. And I was kind of scared that it was like a fantasy one, but I don't think it is. Please correct me if I'm wrong on that. But now I've actually read ACOTAR, I wouldn't mind if it was a fantasy, so I'm kind of over that fear. I then have the entirety of the If Love series by that same author. I just have not got around to reading it yet, and I found out I did start book one, like literally a couple of pages in, but I believe that book one and two are the same couple, and that just really put me off. So I will get around to reading them at some point because they are only like short, but I just wasn't in the mood for that at that time. So I haven't read them yet, but I did actually buy the whole series before realising that number one and two were the same couple, which is annoying. I then have The Cruel Prince, which is a part of a series as well. I don't actually know what this series is called. Oh, this is the Folk of the Air series by Holly Black. I do have the other ones on my Kindle, so I do want to get around to reading this. Have had it for a while, and again, it's a fantasy, so I was scared. I'm no longer scared, so I should get around to reading this like quite soonish, maybe over the next couple of months. I have From Lukov, is that how you say it? Lukov With Love by Marina Zapata. How do you say that? I never know how to say it. I again have had this book for a while, just haven't got around to reading it yet, but it's a hockey romance. People say they like it, so I'm just gonna pick it up soon. Then I have One of the Girls, which was actually on my March TBR. However, I'm having a bit of a slump at the moment due to like some things in my personal life, so I just haven't got around to reading this yet, but I do actually really want to read it, and I'm in the mood for mysteries at the moment, so hopefully I should get to this quite soon. I then have Killer Instinct, which is the second book in the Natural series. I've just read the first book and absolutely loved it, so I'm gonna get to this really soon. This is really high on my TBR priority list, so I'll definitely be getting to this and the rest of the series. I just haven't bought the rest of the series yet. Then have The Locked Door and Never Lie by Freda McFadden. Both are like thriller type books. They're both really short. Again, like I said, I'm in the mood for like mystery, thrillery type books, so I am going to get around to these really soon. I then have The Silent Patient, which again is a recent buy for me. I've been wanting this book for so long, and I am definitely reading this really soon because I'm really excited to read it and I've waited ages to read it. Now this is where it gets slightly more difficult because I have books on both layer, on both like at the front and at the back. I might just take the front ones off. I have Right Girl, Wrong Side, which I literally just picked this up when I was at the works before and just was like, that looks like a nice, cute summary read, and just haven't picked it up since. So I'm sure I'll get to this at some point, just it's not a priority. I then have Mr. Right Next Door, which I was actually sent by Mills and Boone. So thank you, Mills and Boone. This was sent to me a while ago, actually. But I was reading some of the other books that they sent me, including like The 7 Year Slip. And I think it was Until I Met You. Is that by Amber Rose Gill? That book. That was quite good, actually. Cute summary read. Just haven't got around to reading this one yet, but I do want to read it. Probably again, more summery type weather. I'm in the mood for romances when it's just a bit warmer outside. I then have The Fate Mate by Lana Ferguson, which is a recent purchase. I have my reservations about this book due to it being like a werewolf romance. That's not really my thing, but again, now I've been reading more fantasy, I might actually enjoy it. I don't know. I've just picked it up, see if I'm going to like it. If I do, then I'm going to get Bride by Ellie Hazelwood, but I wanted to just try this one first because this one had better reviews than Bride, so yeah. I then have The Night Shift, which I think is like a cute sportsy type romance, maybe set at a school or something, I'm not too sure. Then have The Visa by Lizzie O'Hagan. Again, I'm just kind of waiting for like warmer weather. This is giving like summery vibes, so I'm just trying to just wait for the weather to be a bit nicer to actually start picking up books like this. I then have How to Fake It in Hollywood. Again, it's just a romancy book. If I don't get to it this year, I'm probably going to unhaul it because it's not calling my name. Let me know if you've read this and your thoughts on it, like whether I should keep it or not. I'm just kind of, yeah, I'm not reaching for it on my bookshelf. Then have Adult Assembly Required by Abby Waxman. I have no idea what this book is about whatsoever, but the cover was really cute. I think I might have actually been gifted this book for my birthday or something, but it looks cute. I will read it, just it's not a priority. Then have A Brush With Love by Maisie Eddings. Again, this was kind of like, I think, a book that I bought from the works at some point last year. I just haven't got around to reading it yet and just trying to, again, wait for me to be in the mood for romances. That's literally what I'm going to say the whole time I go through the shelf. Then have One Italian Summer, which I'm just waiting for warmer weather. Again, I'm just like waiting for summer to come for me to read this book. And then have 28 Summers by Ellen Hildebrand. I'm really excited to read this book, but again, I'm just trying to wait for summer so then I'm more in the mood for it. The weather's there. I can probably read it outside, either at a picnic or go to the beach or something, and I just want all the summer vibes when I read this book. Then have Nora Goes Off Script, which was a book that I was actually given for Christmas. So I haven't had it too long, just a couple of months, and I just haven't got around to reading it yet, but it is like on my spring TBR. So I will get to this quite soon, I think. It's only like a short reads. And then the last one on this little bit of the shelf is Love in the Time of Serial Killers. As you can see, I've got like halfway through the book. I just ended up putting it down, not finishing it. I do want to finish it at some point, but it just wasn't what I thought it was going to be. So it just wasn't giving what I thought it was going to give, to be honest. I've got Cleopatra and Frankenstein by Coco Mellors. Again, I do really want to get around to this book, just haven't got round to it yet, but it is quite high on my TBR, and it was actually one of my 24 books that I want to read in 2024, so I will be reading it this year. I then have My Dark Romeo, which is actually a new book that I've just bought, and it is high on my TBR. I do really want to get round to this soon. I have no idea what this book is about. I then have Summer Reading by Jen McKinley. As you can tell, I'm waiting for summer to read this book. That's all I'm going to say about it. I then have Breakaway by Grace Riley. I was actually gifted this book, and I'm really wanting to get around to reading it. I love a hockey romance. I just haven't got around to it yet. I then have The X Talk by Rachel Lynn Solomon. I just haven't got around to this book yet, to be honest. Again, I hauled loads of books last year. I think it was around my birthday time. I had like £200 or something, and I spent most of it on books. Just haven't got around to reading it yet, so yeah. Do with that what you will. Yours Truly by Abby Jimenez, or Jimenez, however you say her name. Again, this has been on my TBR like for a few months. Well, I've actually had it on my physical TBR for a while, but I've had it in a couple of like my monthly TBRs that I wanted to read, and I just haven't got around to it, to be honest. But I do want to, so I'm going to read this super soon because so many people have said great things about it, and I've got FOMO that I haven't read it yet. I then have Weather Girl, which is I'm gonna have to change my bookshelf around because this is also by Rachel Lynn Solomon, which I did not know, and I've been having them separately this whole time. That's gonna bug me, so I'm gonna have to change my bookshelf rounds to accommodate that. But yeah, again, just haven't got around to this one yet. I then have The Do-Over by Lynn Painter. This is actually a recent purchase. How adorable is this purple cover? I think it's so, so cute. I will get around to this really soon, actually, because I'm kind of wanting a quick book. And this is a quick book, as I'm in a bit of a slump at the moment. So, yeah, but I am going to get around to this really soon. And I've heard great things about it. And just Lynn Painter in general. So, we love her. I then have Mr. Wrong Number, which is also by Lynn Painter. I bought this book literally last year when I went on holiday to Poland. And just haven't read it since. I actually didn't know it was by Lynn Painter. I feel like if I did, I probably would have picked it up sooner. I then have Better Than the Movies, which again is by Lynn Painter, and I've heard such good things about this book. So many of you have told me to read it and I just haven't got to it yet. Picking Daisies on Sundays, which I have just bought, so that's why I haven't read it yet. That's my excuse. But I am going to read this very, very soon. It sounds adorable and the cover is just so beautiful. How pretty is that? I love it. So I will get around to this soon. Definitely. We now have the bottom shelf, which you can't see, but I'm just going to grab the books and show you. We had If He Had Been With Me by Laura Nolan. I have recently purchased this book, which is the case with so many books I've said in this video. But like I said, I've been doing a lot of book shopping recently. I'm scared of this book. I want to read it. I am scared of it. So when I've stopped being scared, I will read it. I have Before We Were Strangers, which is again a recent book that I've bought. I think is it a Friends to Lovers or Friends to Lovers to Strangers or whatever? I'm not sure. But yeah, heard great things. I will get to this soon. It's just I have other books that are a priority at the moment. I then have The Secret History by Donna Tartt, which I'm kind of waiting for more autumny weather to read, as I feel like dark academia books need to be read in rainy autumny weather. Then have A Million Kisses in Your Lifetime by Monica Murphy, which is part of the Lancaster Prep series. Have my reservations about this. Also, at the time I bought these pink sprayed edges and now I don't want them. I would like a normal version of this book. And it also has this stupid sticker on. Asda, I know this is for Tickle Pink and it's a good cause. I don't want a fake sticker. I don't want a thingy sticker. I don't want it on there. Then have Powerless by Lauren Roberts, which I do really, really want to get to soon. I've heard great, great things about this. And Sarah Carolli absolutely loves this book. So if she says it's good, I'm going to trust her. I really want to read this book. Just haven't got to it yet. I'm hoping to fly through my April TBR and then I can read this one. But we'll see. I do really want to get to it really soon. I then have Once Upon a Broken Heart by Stephanie Garber, which is the first book in the Once Upon a Broken Heart series. I haven't read the other series by her, Do Not Come For Me. I want to read this one first. Do not shout at me for not reading the other one. But again, I feel like this is more romantic-y, so I feel like I'm going to like this one better. I then have A Good Girl's Guide to Murder, which is the first book in the A Good Girl's Guide to Murder series. I do really want to get to this book. I think it's on my April TBR. So I do really want to get to this. I just haven't got around to it yet, but I am in the mood for mystery type books. And I only have the first book in the series. I haven't bought the whole series yet. I then have A Little Life. I'm just scared. I'm scared. That's why I haven't read it. I'm just scared. I have Convenience Store Woman. I'm not gonna lie, I purely bought this book for the soy sauce fish on the front, but it's only short, so I'm gonna get to this quite soon. Again, I think this is on my April TBR. I then have Bunny, which I do want to get to, but I'm scared of this book again. I'm not quite sure what it's about, but I've heard it be described as like a fever dream. Yeah, I will get to this. I do really, really, really want to read it. I just haven't got to it yet and I am now quite scared of this book. I then have Dear Dolly by Dolly Alderton, which I absolutely love Dolly Alderton's writing. I just haven't picked up this book yet, but I do want to read it quite soon, actually. I don't know why, but this book's just giving me spring vibes. Then I have Funny You Should Ask by Elisa Sussman. Again, I've recently bought this book. I then have Practice Makes Perfect by Sarah Adams, which is part of the Interconnected standalone series with When in Rome. Absolutely loved When in Rome. I only recently read it, so that's why I haven't read this one just yet. But I will be getting to this soon. It's given me spring vibes and I just loved that book. So I will be picking this up very, very soon. I then have Indigo Ridge by Demony Perry, which is again a recent purchase. I do want to get to this soon as well. It's just, yeah, I think it's like a small town type romance. It's the first book in the Eden series. And there's a lot of books in that series, I think. But I just thought I won't challenge myself and I'll just get the first one. I then have Swift and Saddled by Lila Sage, which is a new book that's just come out and I've recently read Done and Dusted, which I am obsessed with. So I will be getting to this book very soon. And again, I think this might be on my April TBR. So keep your eyes peeled for that. I then have The Fake Out by Stephanie Archer, which again is a recent purchase. And again, I've heard super good things about this. I think it's like a reverse Grumpy Sunshine fake dating hockey romance. All the things we love, and so many people have said such good things about this. Now, this is a bit of an awkward angle, but I actually do have a secret cupboard. Please excuse the mess. Don't judge. It's full. But I do have a secret cupboard where there are more books and other things. I have The Book of Fire, which I was actually gifted as part of an influencer campaign. I just haven't got around to reading this yet, but I am going to read it. It's just obviously quite a long book. But this is now in the works. I haven't actually heard too much about this since I was gifted it. But it's the same book as the author who wrote The Beekeeper of, is it Aleppo or some, however you pronounce that. This is the same author that writes this book. I have some Christmassy books in here that obviously are to be read seasonally. So I haven't got round to those yet. So I have All I Want for Christmas, which I was actually gifted for this Christmas. I don't know what it's about, but I know it's a Christmassy romance. So I then have One Last Gift. Again, don't know what this is about. This is by Emily Stone. And then I have The Christmas Wedding Guest by Susan Mallory. Just haven't got round to reading them, as you can only read so many books in the Christmas season. I then have some mystery style books that I just haven't got to yet. So I have The Ex-Husband by Karen Hamilton, 21st Birthday by James Patterson, We Know by Greg Horwitz, is that how you say that? The Lion Game by Tess Stimson, is that how you say that? And The Wild Girls by Phoebe Morgan. And I have two miniature books sitting in the back of there. So I have Altogether Dead by, oh my god, I do not know how to say that name. And then According to Yes by Dawn French. I then have Vera Wong's Unsolicited Advice for Murderers, Killers of a Certain Age by Deanna Rayborn, is that how you say that? Again, it's kind of like Thursday Murder Club vibes, so if you liked Thursday Murder Club then you're probably gonna like these ones, I think. Then I have a big old stack of witch romances, which again are kind of, I'm kind of saving them for seasonal reading. So I have Seduced by the Enemy, which is actually gifted to me by Mills and Boons again, so thank you Mills and Boon for this book. I am going to read it around Halloween time. The League of Gentlewoman Witches, which I don't know too much about, but this is by India Holter, A Witch's Guide to Fate Dating a Demon. I have two books from the same series, and I'm pretty sure I have like the first and the fourth. I don't know what the series is called, but I have Payback's a Witch and Back in a Spell. I have Hex Appeal by Kate Johnson. I also have Her Majesty's Royal Coven, which I'm not sure when this came out, but I know it was like hyped up last year. I just haven't got around to reading it yet. Again, I feel like I need spooky seasonal vibes to read this book. And then on a whim, I bought Becoming Molly May and I just haven't picked it up or wanted to pick it up since. I then have The Song of Achilles and They Both Die in the End. I then have two of the books from, I don't know what this series is called. No, no, I've read that one. I don't have two. I have one of the books from this series. I don't know what this series is called. Meet Me Something series, maybe. It's Meet Me in Tahiti and it's by Georgia Toffolo. I have read two of the books in this series. So I've read Meet Me in Hawaii and Meet Me at the Wedding. I didn't know there were a series until I read Meet Me at the Wedding and I was like, oh, there's other books. So I haven't read this one and I have not read the first one, but I've read like the second and the fourth, or the third and the fourth. Anyway, yeah, I just haven't read this one yet. Then I have a big old stack of Christmas romances, so I'm not going to get them all out, I'm just going to read them to you. I don't know if they're all Christmassy, but then I think they are. So I have A Surprise Christmas Wedding by Philippa Ashley, Christmas at the Little Waffle Shack by Helen Rolfe, 21 Nights in Paris by Leonie Mack, Dashing Through the Snow by Debbie McComber, however you say that, Finding Love at the Christmas Market by Joe Thomas, Christmas Shopaholic by Sophie Kinsella, The Little Shop of Hopes and Dreams by Fiona Harper, One Night in Edinburgh by Nina Kay, All About Us by Tom Ellen, I think. And then The Merry Christmas Project by Kathy Bromley, or Bramley. And then I also have Wuthering Heights by Emily Bronte, Jane Austen's Sense and Sensibility, Emma, and Pride and Prejudice. So I'm not getting them all out because it's awkward to get them back in, but I have all of those books. I have two books by Taylor Jenkins Reid. So I have Daisy Jones and the Six and Malibu Rising. I then have How to Kill Your Family by Bella Mackey, Where the Crawdads Sing by Delilah. Is that how you say it? Delilah Owens. Again, heard great things. There is a film about this now, but I don't want to watch the film until I've read the book. I have The Essex Serpent by Sarah Perry, which I actually got for free when I ordered one of my blind dates with a book. I then have The House in the Carulian Sea by TJ Clune. This is a recent purchase, so I'm gonna get to that soon. And then have The Maid by Nita Prose. I also have just recently purchased this. And then I have Before the Coffee Gets Cold, which I did start and then I just didn't finish, but I do actually want to read this book and maybe the others in the series too, but I only have that one so far. And I have The Bullet That Missed by Richard Osmond, which is actually part of the Thursday Murder Club series. I just haven't read this one, but I have read the other two. This is getting a little bit awkward to show you the book, so I'm kind of just having to pull them all out. But I have The Red Ribbon by Lucy Adlington. I think this is like maybe a mystery. I have Alice Bliss by Laura Harrington. And I have When We Collided by Emery Lloyd. I then have The X Next Door by Jo Platt, which is a romance, I believe. And then I have Before and Nothing More by Anna Todd, which I think I linked to the After series. I then have An Abundance of Catherines by John Green, which is the only John Green book that I haven't read. I have read all these other books and actually really, really like them. I didn't realise this was so short, so I might actually get to this soon. I then have The Magpie Society, which is written by Zoe Sugg and Amy... I don't know how you say her last name, but I believe this is kind of like a mystery type book, but I haven't got to it yet, probably because it's a hardback. But and then I also have The Cassandra Complex by Holly Smale. Is that how you say her name? I then have a stack of like mystery murdery type books. So I have Five Girls Lied and Five Girls Died, which is The Cheerleaders by Cara Thomas. So I'm excited to read that one. I don't really know what it's about, but it sounds interesting. I then have The Vanishing of Audrey Wilde, which I did start reading, I just didn't get very far. I then have It's Behind You by Catherine Foxfield. Again, I did start reading this last year and then I just didn't get very far. Books are falling down behind me. And then I have three books by Karen McManus, which I literally love these books, the other ones in the series. So I have You'll Be the Death of Me, Nothing More to Tell, and The Cousins. And there is a new one coming out soon, which I believe is called One of Us is Back from The One of Us is Dead. What's it called? One of Us is Lying series. And then I have Katie Brent's most recent book called The Murder After the Night Before, which I have recently purchased and I've heard great things about this. She's the same author that wrote How to Kill Men and Get Away with It, and that book was really good. I then have Little Fires Everywhere by Celeste NG, is that how you say it? I have started reading this book and I have got like halfway through, but I just didn't finish it and I do not remember anything. So I'm probably going to have to restart it, but I do actually really want to read this book. I then have Hold Back the Stars by Katie Kahn. I think I must have picked this up in like Aldi in the middle aisle. I just haven't read it yet and I don't know what it's about. And then I have All the Stars Were Burning Brightly by Danelle. I do not know how to say her last name. Again, I have no idea what that's about. And then I have The Handmaid's Tale by Margaret Atwood, which I've heard good things about and obviously quite popular. I started it, I just haven't finished it. Again, have some more romancy books to go through. So I have Highly Suspicious and Unfairly Cute by Talia Hibbert, I think you say that. Again, I saw this in the works and I've seen this on like BookTok quite a bit, so. I then have Get a Life, Chloe Brown by Talia Hibbert. Oh my god, I did not know they were by the same person. Oh, I need to start checking who authors are. Which I think this is part of another series, but I'm not sure. I then have Twice Shy by Sarah Hogle, however you say that. Again, this was like another works, probably in the 3 for 6. Then we have Love at First Fight by Mary Jane Baker. This intrigued me because I love enemies to lovers romance. So then I have 8 Perfect Hours by Leah Lewis, which again was another, I think probably 3 for 6 at the works, but I do want to read it at some point. It's just getting to them. Then I have a big stack of romance ones down here. So I have An Endless Cornish Summer by Philippa Ashley. I have The Kiss by, I don't know who that's by. Is that the author? I think that's the author. This is only a short book, so I'm probably going to read that soon. Then I've got We'll Meet Again by Anton de Beek. How do you say that? Meant to Be Mine by Hannah Orenstein. I just have so many romances I just haven't read yet. Then I have Just My Type by Fallon Ballard. Now, I hadn't heard anything about this when I bought this book, but since then I have seen a lot of people read it and give it good reviews, so I'm probably going to read that soon. Then I have Cornish Dreams at Cockleshell Cottage by Liz Hurley, I think. Then I have Recipe for Mr. Right by Annie Rose. I just have so many romances. I think most of these are like probably from the works. Then I have Take a Chance on Me by Beth Moran, or is that how you say her name? I think so. And Falling Hard for the Royal Guard by Megan Clawson. The last book in this cupboard is 1,000 Boy Kisses by Tilly Cole, which I have recently purchased and do want to get around to reading. I've been wanting to read this for a while, but I was hoping that another cover would have come out by now, and it has not, so I just had to give in and I bought it on Vinted secondhand. So those are all of my bookshelves, but I then do have 2 books that I have started and not finished yet. So that is Conversations on Love by Natasha Lunn and The Final Couple by Kelly Jean Salve, I think you pronounce her name, which she kindly gifted me this book, so thank you so much, Kelly. So those are all the books on my physical TBR. I'm going to do a count and put on the screen how many books were there. I reckon we've just gone through over 100 books, so I definitely need to be doing a TBR takedown, because my God, I forgot how many books I had. I think because I only see these ones and I forget about the ones in the cupboard because they're hidden away and outside out of mind and all that, I think I just forget how many I have. But it's becoming a problem because all my books used to fit in that cupboard and it got overwhelming. So I bought my cart and that got full. Then I bought this and now this is full. So everything is full and it's a problem. Let me know if there's any specific books you want me to get to like first, or there's any that you think that ain't good, give it a miss. But yeah, just let me know. And now I'm going to be doing lots of TBR takedown videos to get through all of those books. I am overwhelmed with the amount of books that I've now got to read. I need to stop buying them, I think, for a while. I have asked for some for my birthday, but I'm trying to get down a lot of books by my birthday. I can't give you like an exact figure on what I want to get down to because I actually don't know how many I have right now. But in my first TBR takedown video, I will talk about like how many books I'm trying to get down to, because obviously I will then know once I've edited this how many books there are, because I'm just going to tally them up as I'm editing. But that's a lot of books and I'm overwhelmed. Thank you for watching today's video. Hope you found it interesting, and like I said, please let me know any books that you think I should get to first, and I should prioritise, because my gosh, I need to write a priority list because there's so many to pick from. But yeah, thank you for sitting through today's video with me, and I hope to see you super soon, hopefully in our TBR takedown series, which will be starting imminently after looking through all of these books.